Well, my friends, this is something new. This is the Week in Automotive News for Friday, August 19th, 2016. And we're doing it from the cockpit of a McLaren 570S. The big news this week is what's going on in California, specifically in Monterey. And it's just automotive nirvana there this weekend. Our friends at Singer Vehicle Design are showing two new recent restorations, one Targa, one Coupe, and they're both absolutely gorgeous. As well, there's rumored to be a total of 8 Singer restorations in the Monterey Peninsula this week, and that should be really, really cool. McLaren is also showing a 570 GT that's been personalized, if you will, by MSO, McLaren Special Operations. Looks absolutely gorgeous. Of course, Bugatti is there showing the Chiron, and rumor is that they've already sold 200 of the 1,500 horsepower hypercars, and we can't wait to get our hands on one of those. Cadillac's also showing the Escala, I think, and it's a big sedan from Cadillac. I guess the idea is to show where the design language of the future is going for Cadillac, but what's interesting is that it's powered by a twin turbo V8. Now, why that's interesting is because the Corvette might be looking for a twin turbo V8, and the Corvette racing program might need such an engine for homologation. So keep your eyes peeled on that one, and don't tell me you heard it here first. Of course, there's nothing like this week in Monterey, so keep your eyes peeled on your social feeds. It'll be just a smorgasbord of automotive delights. On the other side of the US, there's something completely different going on, the Woodward Dream Cruise, and lots of American muscle there to be sure. Our friends at SRT are showing the new Challenger TA and Charger Daytona. Look at you jerks, just drive like a normal person, please. Anyway, that's a great segue to our next bit of news, an autonomous vehicle news. Ford has announced they will have commercially available autonomous vehicles by 2021, which seems to be a common goal among a bunch of automakers. Now, they're saying they are going to be completely driverless, and you know that will be interesting. But what's even more interesting this week is that Uber and Volvo have announced that they're going to have fully autonomous vehicles, although supervised by humans, running in Pittsburgh. This isn't happening in 5 years. This isn't happening next year. No, it's happening this month. So we're gonna have to check it out in Pittsburgh and see how Uber and Volvo are actually doing this. I'm really interested in this for a bunch of reasons, and it's mostly getting people who shouldn't be driving off the roads and getting autonomous cars taking their place. It'd be, I think, a much safer, much more predictable world if some people aren't driving on public roads. I should apologize to BBC World Service. I'm sorry I didn't get your message at 3 in the morning. Yes, I would have loved to have been on the BBC to discuss autonomous cars, but 3 in the morning I was actually sleeping. So feel free to reach out to me anytime, just not at 3 in the morning, Toronto time. Honda's shown the 5-door version of the new Civic, which is an outstanding car. 5-door trim, I think it's much more compelling and certainly much more usable. But what's more interesting is that they're saying that car is going to form the basis of the new SI or SIR. And that is a car that's near and dear to my heart. In news out of Europe, rumor is that Aston Martin is testing the AMG 4-liter twin-turbo V8 in the DB11, and that engine is definitely bound for the new Vantage, so we'll definitely see that. Yes, I'm talking to the camera, thank you. Your camber settings are all wrong in that car, by the way. Anyway, we know that the AMG motors are coming. We have recently driven the new DB11, and what a car that is. I do think it makes more than the 600 horsepower they say it does, and you know, we'll see when we get one of those on a dyno. In other European news, rumor is that Bentley is going to be showing the new Continental at the Paris Motor Show this fall, so watch out for that. That should be interesting. Also, the rumor is that it's going to be much, much lighter than the previous model. In another bit of news that's near and dear to my heart, the Nissan Titan is getting a big, big warranty, 5 years or 160,000 kilometers, or in the US, I think it's 5 years and 100,000 miles, and that's pretty amazing. I've already put on, I don't know, 7,000 kilometers on our Nissan Titan that we use to haul our Guelph and Waterloo Nissan Micro Cup race car. The thing has been absolutely flawless. It tows the trailer and the race car with total ease. It's kind of a joke, actually, because I have the feeling that it'll tow at about 170 kilometers an hour or 105 miles an hour. Like, it's just, it's insane. The truck is really fantastic, and the only complaint I have about it is it doesn't have Apple CarPlay, and Nissan's really slow at picking up the Apple CarPlay game. But then again, this this McLaren doesn't have it either, but I'll tell you, their Iris infotainment system is fantastic, and I love the McLaren aesthetic, and we'll get into that a little bit more on our piece about this 570S. Anyway, that's enough about the automotive news for the week of Friday, August 19th, 2016. Hope you liked it. Please let us know what you think about this format as well. Definitely looking forward to your feedback. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you again next time.